one brutal blow.
Austin just broke the end of that shovel. The Undertaker's face.
Now, a bitter feud cannot die until one man is buried alive.
There will be no resting in peace now.
The Undertaker.
If you think I ain't pissed, you got another thing coming.
Stone Cold Steve Austin. WWF Rock Bottom. Presented live by Glover. This Sunday on pay-per-view.
Comes the rattlesnake, JR. He's gotta be shaking in his boots, you think?
His opponent from Victoria, Texas, weighing 252 pounds, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
An evil reptile in his first ever buried alive match here in Vancouver.
Yeah, he's looking over and inspecting what may be his own gravesite.
And the Undertaker has never lost a buried alive match to our knowledge. Austin, to our knowledge, has never been in one.
Austin, here he comes. Whoa!
That quick sneak going off that hill of dirt.
Right there. Austin going for a clothesline. Didn't even take the Undertaker off his feet.
Remember, there's no countouts. There's no disqualifications in this match. The match ends and one man is literally buried alive.
Oh, look at this. Austin ramming the Undertaker into that barrier.
The Undertaker using whatever he can, whatever he wants, and it's all legal. The referee just going to stand back. That's all he can do right now is stand back.
Hello, and welcome back to more WWE 2K16, and we're playing more Showcase, and as you can see, another match with the Undertaker, which is great. And I have to say, that music is, I don't think I mentioned the music in the last one, but the music for The Undertaker at this time, when he was in his ministry phase, was probably his best music, I think. It's just absolutely awesome. And I don't think it had the chanting in there. I couldn't really hear it, but there's one that they released on the I think it's a PlayStation 1, one of the original sort of SmackDown games, and it had the whole sort of chanting entrance and stuff, and it was just amazing. And the metal guitars and stuff and everything just makes the Undertaker character seem a bit more sort of mythical with an electric guitar. It was awesome. And yes, we're doing a buried alive match. Unfortunately, they didn't include this game type in the single player game. So if you're playing through the game and you play in this match, you don't actually unlock it, which seems a bit weird. Probably just due to the fact that they've put in some story elements where they've sort of customized the whole sort of dropping the person into the grave. It's certainly a match that's a little bit more suited for video games and actually seeing it in real life, because in real life there's a lot of waiting around, and you know, somebody sort of rolls you in, and then that's, they've got to sort of put soil and stuff on top of you, and it just, it's a bit, you've got to suspend your belief a little bit in these sort of match types, but it's not as bad as some like ladder matches and stuff where people forget how to climb up ladders and whatnot, but we'll get to one of those soon, don't worry. So let's just run through some of the things that I suppose make A, The Undertaker really interesting, and B, what was involved in your house, Rock Bottom, or Rock Bottom, as it was called. And one thing that is amazing, as I mentioned in the last one, obviously he looks a bit older in the game than he did at this stage in real life. The weight and stuff looks about right on him, because he's a lot thinner now, because obviously he's got older, but this stage he looked a bit sort of like chunky, like podgy sort of version of The Undertaker, but nonetheless still like an imposing guy at like 6 foot something or other. Super tall, super big, and he could get around the ring pretty quickly as well. Obviously, The Undertaker just had a match there at Survivor Series as I was recording it. It's recording this, so 2015 Survivor Series saw The Undertaker return with Kane, and they were feuding with the Wyatt family. And I haven't watched it, to be honest with you. I don't watch a lot of wrestling these days, but I sort of catch up on the news from the Law and the Fight Network and stuff like that, and just sort of listen to their sort of overviews of what happened, and a lot of the time it will convince me to go and watch the events, but this time it didn't really sell me. I don't think those guys were too impressed with it. So the Kane and the Undertaker match, I might catch some highlights of at some stage, but at the moment I'm not too enthused by going to see it, taking time to see it. But 25 years The Undertaker's been going for, which is pretty incredible. I mean, whenever I was sort of really, really young, one of my earliest sort of action figures I got was the Undertaker, and it was a really sort of sought after figure at the time. It completely defied all sort of what the WWF at the time was trying to do, which was trying to make Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior seem like they were incredible. You know, they were the unstoppable guys. Yes, you can punch Paul Bearer, by the way, as well. Seems unfair punching a man of that size, but there you go. It's good the fact that they've left that in. And I just remember getting the Undertaker figure and being completely smitten with wrestling pretty much after that, even more so than before. But a great figure, and I still have it somewhere today as well, which is awesome. It was back when he was a lot more ginger. Anyway, Goldberg took on Matt Hardy for the light heavyweight championship, and Goldberg was obviously the ripoff of Goldberg, the parody of Goldberg. Second match was Kevin Quinn versus Brian Christopher. I have no idea who Kevin Quinn was, but he defeated Brian Christopher anyway, or Grandmaster Sexay, as he would later become. And Triple H defeated Droz. I wasn't too familiar with him. I mean, obviously know who he was now, and you know what he was all about, but back then didn't ring a bell with me. Match 4 was the New Age Outlaws, Road Dogg and Billy Gunn, and they defeated the Acolytes, frickin' Bradshaw. Great tag team, one of my favourite tag teams of all time, I think, the Acolytes. Match 5 was Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown, with Terry Runnels and Jacqueline defeating Supply and Demand, the Godfather and Val Venus, which just sounds like so 90s. Supply and Demand, there was a lot of drug references and hoe references and all that sort of stuff going on in the 90s, late 90s, and that just emphasises that so much. And Terry and Jacqueline were probably treated like whores in the match, let's be fair, but 90s, you couldn't get out of this stuff now. Match 6 was the Headbangers, Mosh and Thrasher, a lot of tag team matches on this card, versus the Oddities, Kurgan and Goga, with Giant Silva and Luna Vachon, and the Headbangers defeated the Oddities. I think this is towards the end of the Oddities run in WWE. Steve Blackman defeated Owen Hart by count out. That would have been a pretty interesting match. And match 8 was The Brood, Edge, Christian and Gangrel defeating the Job Squad, which is Al Snow and Scorpio and Bob Holly.
Closer these two get to that grave site.
Undertaker, often buried alive. A real walking, talking slobber knocker.
Oh no, oh look at that shot. Oh no, JR. Stone Cold's in the grave.
Will Austin be buried alive by the Undertaker? Or can Austin somehow, some way survive?
Oh no, the dead man's going after that shovel. But look, Austin's moving.
Austin's got a heartbeat. Austin's alive. Austin's getting out of the grave.
Stone Cold lived to fight him. Oh, what a battle this has been, JR. The Undertaker trying to get Steve Austin into that grave.
These are career-shortening matches, to say the least. Austin with a right hand.
Oh, wait. Undertaker teetering here. Look at this. JR!
Austin with a stunner.
And the Undertaker fell into the grave.
Austin stuns the Undertaker all the way to hell in that grave.
And there goes the dirt. The Undertaker is buried alive.
Paul Bearer in panic. Paul Bearer waddling off. Where's he going? Austin now getting out of harm's way.
Look!
Through hellfire and brimstone, the explosion of explosions.
The Undertaker crawling back up out of that grave.
He's alive. The Undertaker is alive. But now what?
What?
My God, it's Kane. What in the hell is going on? This is.
There you go, bit of a turn up for the books, getting to play as Kane in Austin's storyline mode, but there you go. Going back to where I was, obviously, I don't think I need to explain the story mode there. It was pretty awesome with the whole Austin getting thrown into the grave and stuff, but you'll see some more coming up soon. But let's go back to just what was on the match card for the rest of Rock Bottom. So, as I say, match 8 was the Brood versus the Job Squad. Match 9 was Goldust defeating Jeff Jarrett with Deborah by disqualification in a striptease match. Maybe you should Google that one. Match 10 was the New Age Outlaws again defeating the Corporation, which was Big Boss Man and Kem Shamrock, with Shawn Michaels, probably a drug-addled Shawn Michaels at this stage in 1998, and that was for the WWF Tag Team Championship. And then, of course, match 11 was Mankind defeating The Rock with Mr. McMahon and Shane McMahon, and that was for the WWF Championship. So, there you go. Full-on rundown of the match card there. I hope you're enjoying those rundowns. It makes it a little bit more sort of interesting, because I can't just sort of keep talking about the gameplay, because I've talked about the gameplay in previous videos, so hopefully you appreciate a little bit more history about these pay-per-view events that they don't show. I sort of think that they should have done perhaps more of a job in sort of introducing the run-up to this specific match, because they do miss out on quite a lot there. That I've had to sort of either put in or just talk about, but I'm hopefully going to have something to be putting that I'll put in at the start of the video. But there you go. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.
Oh no, JR. These two demonic brothers are literally beating the hell out of each other.
Man, what a dysfunctional family reunion we're watching here in this buried alive match. Undertaker and Kane.
Watch out. Kane with the headbutt. Undertaker's down. He's teetering near that grave, JR.
Kane's down. Kane almost had the advantage. That low blow will stop any man.
Oh, this is going to be it for Kane, I'm afraid, JR. No, wait. Look at this.
Oh, Kane slides out the back door. And Kane now reverses the Undertaker.
Oh,
Kane,
no.
Can Kane hit the tombstone? That's the question here.
Oh, my God.
Good grief. And the Undertaker is thrown into the grave.
And look at this. Kane. Kane has tombstone the Undertaker.
Now, can somebody tell me what the hell is going on?
What in the world, JR? Is that a backhoe being driven in here?
First, a dysfunctional family reunion, and now a backhoe is being brought into play.
Stone Cold Steve Austin has commandeered a backhoe.
Good God Almighty, what's next, ladies and gentlemen? What is next?
This is unbelievable. And now that backhoe is going into operation here.
Kane tombstoning his brother, the Undertaker, into the grave. And now Austin directing traffic wants that backhoe operator to back it up, load the bucket with dirt, and bury the Undertaker alive.
I cannot believe what we are seeing here. Austin directing traffic, and now what's Austin doing?
I never thought Austin could beat The Undertaker in a buried alive match.
Oh my gosh, Jared, look.
Are you kidding me?
A couple of cold ones. What is this? A farewell party for The Undertaker?
It's a going away party.
This is unbelievable.
Whose party is this? The celebration has begun with a cold brewski. good God almighty. I've never seen anything like this in my life.